Hello, Internet. Welcome back to our Learning Azure ML series. Last time we created a model based on the two-class decision tree algorithm, and we found out our model was suboptimal, which should be expected since all of our algorithm settings was left on default. So today, I will walk you through how to fine-tune your models in Azure Machine Learning Studio. Now, when you optimize your model, you want to consider the context of your data to figure out what metric you want to optimize. For example, if you were the FBI or a lawyer trying to gather evidence to prosecute, you may care more about the thoroughness of your model and maximize your recall. If, on the other hand, you're trying to build a recommendation system like in Pandora or Netflix, you may care more about the relevancy of your predictions, so you may optimize precision. For the purpose of this video, I will only be optimizing the ROC curve. But once you learn how to optimize one metric, it'll be easy to optimize the others. Specifically, I'm going to be optimizing the AUC, or the area under the ROC curve, based upon a 50-50 threshold, with a goal of trying to get as close to 90% as possible. Alright, so let's do that. Let's tweak the decision force. But first, let's compress our models together so it's nice and compact and vertical. And now we can just simply and copy and paste, and now we have a second model running on the side. Now this model actually has the same parameters as the previous one. And for example, if we wanted to know what the difference was between the resampling methods, whether bagging would perform better, or whether or not if we replicate it and it would perform better. Now let's copy our evaluate model and actually reroute them so that they will be evaluating each other. Now we want to just run our model. Once that's done running, you can now compare the two models by visualizing the evaluate model that's comparing the two models. So you're going to get two separate ROC curves comparing left and the right nodes. So if you remember, the left node is our bagging model, and then our right node is our replicate model. And visually, you can see that bagging as a resampling method outperformed replicate because it is higher under ROC curve. Therefore, it has a higher area under the curve. And sometimes you'll have models that are basically so close that they're basically their ROC curves are stacked on top of each other. And if you want a more precise measurement, you can check the cumulative AUC down here, which gives you the score of the performing model. So between these two models, you can tell that there was about a 4% increase of between bagging and replicate. So moving forward, we now know that we want to choose bagging as our resampling method because of its superior performance over replicate. And then let's ask the question, what would perform better, a decision forest with a few large trees or a decision forest with many small trees? So we've created a situation where we want to compare three models together, and simply put, we need to have an extra model. So just simply and copy and paste for the third model and put it side by side. So you want to have a small tree, big forest, and then you want to have a big tree, small forest. All right, so let's tweak these two algorithms so that they match their description. So for big trees, I want to add the number of depth into the tree. So let's have the tree be actually 128 nodes thick. And then we want to have a fewer number of trees. So let's have four trees of 128 depth. And on the other side, let's have 100 trees instead of 8 trees. And then instead of the trees having a 32 node layer depth, let's have it be, let's change that to 4. And moving forward, I'm just going to remove any confusion, and I'm simply going to call the models left, middle, or right models. So I'm going to show you a quick trick to evaluate three models together. So to do that, you actually need three evaluate models. So just simply select the evaluate model and then copy and paste them, and then simply reroute them. So now that you have these three evaluate modules, you want to compare every single combination of the three. So first of all, you want to have the left and the middle compared to each other. You want the left and the right compared to each other. And lastly, you want the middle and the right compared to one another. And now that you have all your bases covered, just simply hit run the model. So once the cloud is done processing all your algorithms, you want to visualize the evaluation model that's actually evaluating the left and the right module. And then you'll visualize, wow, so you can tell that there is a huge difference in performance between the two modules. So the left module absolutely got smoked by the right module. So having a large forest with small trees seems vastly superior to a small forest with big trees. You can tell that by the difference in these two curves, with the large forest and the small trees being on top. You can also tell the numeric performance of the two models by looking at the cumulative AUC. So on the small forest with the big trees, we have a 0.71 AUC versus the large forest with the small trees, which had a 0.84 AUC, which is a much better performing model. After that evaluation, we now know that the right model is a winning model. And we also know that the left model is also not a winning model, which means these two branches are now worthless. We don't have to look at them, which means we also don't have to look at this evaluate model, which means we can go forward and only look at this evaluate model. So let's go and visualize what's in the evaluate module, comparing the default and the large forest with small trees. And we can also tell again that having a large forest of small trees really outperformed the default tree. And that's all there is to it, right? So to optimize an algorithm, all you have to do is you take a parameter, and then you have three modules competing against each other. The left module is where you decrease the parameter and see what happens, and then the right module, you increase the parameter and see what happens. The middle module is the control module, is where you don't change anything, and then you find which one is the winning module, and then you move forward and repeat back to step number one. But let's go further now. Let's go crazy. Let's say that we weren't happy with the results of our two-class decision force. Let's say 0.84 AUC was not good enough. We can also fine-tune across algorithms. So if you remember, we go back into our machine learning and go back into our classification models. Look at all the two-class algorithms we have at our disposal. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fast forward now, and I'm going to run every model against each other. And I'm actually going to find which model is the best one to use for our Titanic data set. So in a minute and 30 seconds, I've taken eight algorithms, different algorithms, and I've trained them, I've scored them, I've evaluated them against each other, and I found the model of best fit, and I will put the rankings for you on the screen. It looks like the best performing model with default settings is actually the decision jungle. So going forward, we actually might just pick the decision jungle and optimize that instead of optimizing the decision forest, which it looks like actually performed the worst on its default setting. So you will actually notice that the decision jungle on default setting performs better than our optimized two-class decision forest. And that concludes our video on how to optimize and fine-tune your models in Azure ML. So join us next time where I will teach you how to deploy your model once you actually have a model.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.